Jak X Combat Racing for the PS2 is not a game that I actually completed or played too much of because I had a problem later on where the disc would stop saving progress. So, you know, I didn't want to go through the trouble of having to beat the entire game in one sitting. So I just played as much as I could, recorded as much as I could, and this is what I got. So this is just a basic brief overview of what Jak X Combat Racing is. There's a lot of different variety in this game, and that's probably what I really liked about it. But what's also driving forward is the story of the game. Of course, the story concept, the whole plot, is kind of ridiculous and far-fetched. But it's just fun to watch the cutscenes as you race, and there's so many different kinds of driving events. It's not just racing in this game. It's not just combat racing. There's so much, whole bunch of other stuff. Now, the driving physics behind this game ain't all that great. It's really slidey, but there's a lot of different elements in this game that actually makes it really fun. And this is actually my second Jak game that I played. Anyway, this is the story concept that starts the game.
Who called us here anyway?
Crew's daughter, Rain.
Crew had a daughter?
Crew? Reproduced? Ew! Can you imagine what that tub of jelly must look like?
Thank you for coming to Crash City. It looks like some didn't make it. Ah, well. I'm Rain. Before Father died, his wishes were simple. To have his will played for his closest associates, and for us to drink to his passing. This special vintage he kept for the very occasion, to toast his death. Here's to old friends, and to Father's untimely death. Yeah. So without further delay, his message to us.
Hello, nearly friends, and mostly enemies. If you're listening to this message, then I must be dead. Oh, well. As you all know, I loved racing almost as much as I loved weapons. Alas, I never fulfilled my living dream of winning the biggest race of all, the Crash City Grand Championship. But even in death, I will field the greatest racing team ever assembled and win the biggest race on the planet. You are the best of the best, and you will race for me.
Never
forget it!
I expect you're all riled up by now, so let me tell you why you will race, and you will win. If all went as planned, you just give a touching toast in my honor. Sorry to say, but I put poison in that special vintage. Quite unsporty, am I right?
Father!
This is where Rain probably gets upset. Sorry, dear. It's a slow-acting poison, or you'd already be dead. You have just enough time to finish this year's racing season. If you race for me and win, my associates will provide you each with an antidote to the poison. Simple, eh?
What the hell did you do to us?
Please, I didn't know. I drank it too. Father never did play favorites.
Yeah? Well, your father's crazy.
We're all crazy for coming here!
I think she's telling the truth.
Well, it's been 1 minute, so I figure by now you're all arguing about how to get out of this mess. My advice is trust no one. Win the race and save yourselves.
Jak, next time you invite me to one of your little parties...
Don't!
We can do this. We can race. And we can beat Crew at his own game.
Father bought us the best mobile racing garage money can buy. And each of you has a racing car waiting. We're in this together. So let's get to it.
Like I said, pretty ridiculous plot device, but it's really interesting. Anyway, all the various different kinds of events. This one is attacking drones as you go. So the more you have to kill as many drones as you can in a limited amount of time. And in this particular event, you know, the gold medal is 110. You know, you have to kill 110 drones. There's like, I don't know how many weapons there are, but there are quite a few. And there's like three different elements to this game. There's the green echo, which heals your ship. The blue echo, which you can use as turbo boost. And the red and yellow echo are weapons. The yellow is like the weapon that shoots forward, and red is weapons like mines and bombs that you leave behind. This event is interesting. You gotta hit like different various points to freeze time, and the longer you can stay time, you know. This is the customization mode. The more you race, the more points you earn, and so you can actually customize whatever vehicles you get, and you don't get just one vehicle. So it's a great way to actually increase the engine, the acceleration, the strength of the car, and it really helps. I think this upgrading mechanic actually really makes you want to keep playing the game. It's a really fun little game. And there's weird modes like this, where you have to find turbo balls in the map, and you have to charge it up, and whoever charges up the turbo balls the most wins. I think this is my like least favorite event, because it's just, it ain't all that fun, and some kind of random stuff happens where you can't charge it. But, you know, this is just a demonstration of that. There's so many different variety of modes and events in this game. And there's even stuff like this where you're racing to the artifact. So whoever captures the most artifact in the given amount of time wins. So, you know, there's all kinds of stuff. I mean, probably the most fun thing is the racing itself, just racing around. But, you know, if this game was just about racing, it would be kind of boring, as the mechanics aren't all that fleshed out. I mean, mechanics by itself, something like Mario Kart or even like Crash Team Racing is much more fun, at least in my opinion. But because it's so buried, and because it has cutscene and story to really make this a cohesive experience, I think that's what makes this game really fun. So that's all I wanted to really talk about. So I'm gonna end this video with just a few footages of the race and a little cutscene at the end.
Want some more?
The network has decided, in their infinitesimally small wisdom, to add a co-host to my show. I can't imagine anyone outshining yours truly, but alas, please give a lukewarm welcome to my new color commentator, as it were, Mr. Pecker.
Thank you, GT. And hello to all you peoples out there watching. I'd like to thank the network for choosing me to save this anemic little show.
Yes, well, welcome aboard, Pecker.
That's it! Who's his agent? Pecker always gets the sweet gigs in these adventures.
My first network assignment has been to investigate the rumored super bet on this year's big championship race. Sources say a high-level underworld crime connection is involved. But sadly, my sources won't return calls, and are now missing, and are probably dead. But Pecker is not so easily swayed. I will uncover the truth and report my findings right here on our show, GT.
Of course you will. And let me just say, it's going to be so great working with you.
You too, Blitzman! Oops, sorry.
Why, you little bird shit!